every bit as important. You ask for a pillow, sir?
Ah, thank you.
Because normally I like to have like a sandal with a back on it, you know, so that your toes don't grip then. If they're gripping too much, it's actually bad for your whole posture and you can get really out of it.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is your captain speaking. Good news, it looks like the turbulence has come to an end. Turns out my co-pilot had simply misplaced my epilepsy tablets.
As well as being a bird watcher, I also collect stamps. I collect stamps with birds on them, right from Federation right through to the current native birds you see around and about. I think my mother got me started really in the original
part. Excuse me, is there any chance of me getting an upgrade?
I love birds.
Certainly.
I love birds, I love stamps.
Yes, certainly, certainly. Well, have a nice flight. I hope I'll see you. Could I? Here you go.
Just get you.
Ladies and gentlemen, we've now reached a cruising altitude of 30,000 feet. According to the weather satellite, we should have a smooth flight for the next 6 hours. So if anyone wants to join the Mile High Club, I advise you to make your way to the toilet cubicle now.
Are you going to say something too?
I don't want to. It's embarrassing.
I can't keep doing it. Someone's got to stop them.
Okay. Excuse me, Captain. You're wanted on the flight deck. I think we've been cleared to take off.
Certainly.
And can you tell the first officer we're ready for final checks?
Absolutely. Graham. Final checks.
Oh, excuse me, can you just take care of my baby just while I pack this stuff away?
Certainly, ma'am.
Thank you.
If there's anything else I can help you with, just let me know.
Thank you very much.
Excuse me, sir, may I see your boarding pass?
Why? I'm not gay.
I never said you were, sir. There's been a mix-up with the seating.
Rightio, here you go.
Yes, okay. Now, this seat actually belongs to this gentleman here. You're meant to be seated in 23B.
Yeah, look, I know that. It's just that I sat down there and I thought that seat made me look a bit gay.
How do you mean?
You're the flight attendant. You should know.
Just because I'm a flight attendant, sir, doesn't mean that I'm gay.
Oh, right. And just because I'm a panel beater who spends all day pounding dents out of cars with a huge mallet and my big brawny masculine arms doesn't mean that I like sleeping with women. And lots of them.
No, it doesn't, sir.
Yes, it does.
No, it doesn't. And even if you were gay, it wouldn't matter.
Hey, listen. You keep your poofy theories to yourself, Lavender Boy. I'm staying right here with my penis-free buttocks firmly planted in this straight man's seat.
Hello, I'm Russell. I'm the cabin supervisor. Do we have a problem here?
We certainly do, my faggoty friend. Why don't you ask old Nancy Pants what it is?
Well,
he won't take his correct seat because he feels it makes him look gay.
Look, this is proving to be a real hassle. I'm happy to sit over there.
Hey, no bloody way, mate. No way. Just because these fellas haven't got their act together enough to put enough straight seats on the plane doesn't mean you have to suffer. No, you stick up for yourself.
Look, I don't care where I sit.
Hey, no. That's just not fair. I won't have it. Look, I'll tell you what I'll do. At great compromise to my own personal comfort, I am prepared to let this man share my straight seat with me.
No buts.
No, you come and sit on Daddy's lap. It'll only take a couple of hours.
Thank you for being so understanding, sir. I'll show you to the other seat.
It must be a poof.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're about to begin our descent into Adelaide, so if there are any terrorists aboard, I advise you to hijack the plane now before the seatbelt sign comes on.
Are we there yet? Are we there yet?
Ladies and gentlemen, this is your captain speaking. For the 100th time, we are approximately 2 hours from our destination.
Are we there yet? Are we there yet? Are we there yet?
And I'd just like to warn you that if you don't cut the shit, I'm gonna fly this son of a bitch into the sun. Ladies and gentlemen, this is your captain speaking. We're currently cruising at 30,000 feet, and I'll be turning off the seatbelt sign soon so you can move freely about the cabin. Estimated time of arrival in Perth is 8:30 a.m. I would also like to add that while we are in the air, I own you. I am in control, and your lives are in my hands. From this point on, you are to refer to me only as the Lord of the Skies. Yes, that means you. The cabin crew will soon be passing around a hat, and if you want to get to Perth in one piece, I strongly suggest you make a donation. I also demand that a blonde woman with big norks be chosen and sent to the cockpit as a show of good faith on your part. In the meantime, we hope you have a pleasant flight. And just remember, I own you.
All right! Turn this plane around! We're going back to Sydney!
What seems to be the
Get problem? Get back! I've got this, and I'm not afraid to try and open it.
What's going on in
there? Stand back, Captain! He's got a juice container!
And I'm not afraid to try and open it either.
Good God, man! You open that standing up and juice could go everywhere.
That's why we're turning this crate around, and we're going back to Sydney.
I will not be told what to do on my own aircraft by one lunatic with a juice container!
One lunatic with a juice container? Think again, Captain!
Hello.
Hi.
How are you?
Fine.
It's a longer flight to Australia, hmm?
Yes.
Many, many hours. Hours, yes?
Hours.
Hours, yes. I'm hope we can speak this time. Hours, yes? So I'm learn that good English. I'm hope many hours we speak English so I can learn good English when we arrive.
Arrive.
When we have many hours English, I speak English good like you make.
Look, many do you hours want me to teach you some English?
Please.
Okay. Now, repeat after me. Mm-hmm. Please bring...
Please bring...
Steward, sir?
Please bring me captain. For I have explosive thing in my baggage and I would like to do tonight.
If you could just wait here one minute.
Please, do not punish Boris for bad English. I try to speak good. Please help. Please.
Good afternoon once again, ladies and gentlemen. Captain Jane Donaldson here. I do hope you're having a comfortable trip and that you're enjoying our in-flight service. Right now we're cruising at 33,000 feet and we're just about to start our descent into the sea. The temperature in the sea is currently about minus 2 degrees and we expect to be in it in approximately 50 seconds. If you'd like to hire an emergency rescue vessel to pluck you out of the shark-infested waters, just ask one of our surviving crew members after impact and they'll be happy to make the arrangements. So once again, thank you for flying with us today. Apologies for the catastrophic mid-air disaster, but did you really think you could fly from Melbourne to Darwin for $19 without some shortcuts on safety? Oh, there goes the wing.
Ladies and gentlemen, can I have your attention, please? If there is a doctor on board, could you please make yourself known to the cabin staff immediately? Thank you.
I'm a doctor. Is there a problem?
No. No problem.
Hello, I'm a doctor. Is someone ill?
No. Everybody's fine. Thank you. You can go back to your seat.
Hi there. I heard the announcement. Can I be of any help?
You're a woman!
So, I'm still a doctor.
Look, to be clear, if there are any male, young, unmarried, good-looking doctors on board looking for a relationship with a hot stewardess, can you please come and find me immediately? God, how obvious do you have to make it?
Excuse me, sir. Tea or coffee?
Coffee, thanks.
Nuts?
Yes, please.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the captain. I just wanted to assure you, the sound you heard before was not the main engine failing. The plane is absolutely fine. There's no reason to panic. And I invite you now to sit back and relax. In fact, if you care to look out the windows, you'll see the beautiful Indian Ocean. That's right, just keep looking out the windows, everyone, on each side of the cabin. Just keep looking out the windows. So, definitely nothing to worry about. We're certainly not about to crash. Just keep admiring the view and enjoy the rest of your life. I mean, flight. Enjoy the rest of your flight.
Excuse me.
Yes?
My knife is plastic.
That's right.
Well, how am I supposed to cut up my main meal?
I'm sorry, sir. Everything on the plane's made of plastic now.
Oh, well, this is ridiculous.
Sorry, sir. It's security. Excuse me. What is that?
Oh, it's a bomb.
It's what?
It's all right. It's a plastic explosive.
Sorry, sir. Look, enjoy your flight. At least some people play by the rules. Could I please have everyone's attention? Now, I don't want any of you to panic, but the captain has collapsed. And the co-pilot has come down with food poisoning. Now, I don't suppose any of you know how to fly a plane. Anyone at all?
Yeah. All right, love, I'll give it a go.
Thank God. You a pilot, sir?
Yeah, sort of, darling. I'm a taxi driver. So how's your day been, right?
Sorry, could you hurry up? The plane is late enough as it is.
Yeah, righto, sweetheart. Keep your shirt on. Now, where are we going?
Sydney.
Now, just remind me where that is again. Jesus, watch out, you moron! I don't know, bloody Asian pilots.
Don't you think you should tell the passengers what's going on?
Yeah, all right. Now, listen, this is your captain speaking. Now, look, you ask me, this bloody government's doing nothing to encourage small business. I mean, what does John Howard know about the ordinary person? You know, he just sits down there in his air-conditioned car, says, oh, do this, do that. Now, it's easy enough for him, isn't it? And don't get me started on plane fuel prices. Shit!
Oh,
Jesus!
What now?
I miss your bloody exit. Hang on, I'll do a Yui.
Everybody stand back! Today is the fifth anniversary of Osama bin Laden's glorious attack on the World Trade Center. And I will mark this sacred day by once again striking a magnificent blow against George Bush and his evil...
It's actually the 12th of September.
Sorry, what?
Yeah, today is the 12th of September. We've actually already crossed the international dateline.
You got the time zones wrong, you big duffer.
Oh, bugger, I did too. Oh, don't mind me. Look, I'll do it next year.
شكرا لكم لاختياركم السفر على غولف اير بالنيابة عن الكابتن إبراهيم كل طاقم الطائرة نحن نتمنى لكم رحلة آمنة وممتعة.
Translation: Thank you for choosing to fly Gulf Air on behalf of Captain Ibrahim and the entire crew. We wish you a safe and pleasant flight.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is your captain speaking. Just a quick word to thank you for your understanding with these new in-flight security measures. We know limiting your carry-on items is a bit of an imposition, but if it saves lives, I guess it's worth it. Ladies and gentlemen, this is your captain speaking. Our estimated time of arrival is still 11:30 p.m. Just wanted to assure you that the cabin has not been taken over by a terrorist, and I am not pretending to speak normally to deceive that terrorist into thinking this is a routine announcement. I hope that you are all not staring out the window and ignoring this message, because I think, Allah, you should really listen. If you do look out the window, you will see we have unexpectedly changed course and turned back toward Parliament House. This is no reason to pick up your mobile phones and ring the Air Force.
Don't you hate it when they interrupt the movie to make those stupid announcements?
I wasn't even listening, to be honest. Oh, look at that fantastic view of Parliament House.
Excuse me, everyone. Hi, I'm Shelley. Sorry to interrupt, but I really just have this to say. This is the most enjoyable flight I have ever been on. I think you are all just such lovely, giving people. I think you're all truly warm and attractive people. And so when we land, I want you all to come to the bar because the drinks are on me all night, my treat. Now, I just need to acknowledge like the warmth that I'm feeling for all of you. I mean, ideally, I'd like to take all of us on a round the world trip, you know, like see the world together, but I mean, it's short notice, we probably can't organise that. So anyway, let's forget about it, it's too hard to organise. Anyway, I hope you all have a really lovely time. Come and meet me in the bar and let's spend the night together. My God, you are so beautiful.
What an extraordinary thing. Thank you, you're an extremely generous woman.
Not really. I swallowed a condom full of ecstasy this morning and it just burst. Oh, man, you are so beautiful. Let's make out.
Yeah, it's burst.
Good. So that's what we all have to do in case of an emergency. That concludes our safety demonstration. If you've missed any points, please have a look at your safety card in your front seat pocket.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are currently cruising at an altitude of 30,000 feet. The weather is fine. We're going to be arriving in good time, unless that passenger in the red shirt in seat 4B is acting suspiciously for a reason, in which case we could be in a bit of trouble.
Well, no, I'm all right. I'm just a bit nervous because I've got a whole lot of heroin up me bum.
Great, okay. Well, relax, everybody, and enjoy your flight.
Oh, actually, could I get a cushion? Yeah, cheers.
I need to go to the toilet.
Don't get any smart ideas. I'm coming with you.
She a felon, sir?
Teenage daughter. Rafe Fiennes is on the plane.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome aboard this non-stop flight to New York. The movies available on this flight are the haunting recreation of 9/11, the powerful drama of United 93. The powerful drama of World Trade Center, starring Nicolas Cage, and the light-hearted comedy of Rob Schneider in Deuce Bigelow, European Gigolo.